India on June 15 successfully carried out the night launch of its indigenously developed nuclear-capable Prithvi-II missile from Integrated Test Center in Odisha state of India. The Defense Ministry of India stated the missile met all operational and technical parameters. The short-range ballistic missile Prithvi-II was test-fired on June 15 from an integrated test center at Chandipur, Odisha state of India. Previously, Prithvi-II missile was successfully launched from the ITI in Chandipur on February 21, 2018. Later on November 28, 2019, two successive Prithvi-II trials were accomplished from the same base. The Prithvi missile is a proven system that can hit targets with pinpoint accuracy. Even in the later stage, the launch successfully validated the missile's operational and technical characteristics. The Indian Ministry of Defense started the program to carry out extensive research and develop nuclear-capable missiles. These types of tests are conducted by choosing missiles at random from India's overall military arsenal and production stock. This is done to assess India's progress and emergency preparedness in the event of a war-like situation. The test comes nearly 10 days after India conducted a routine test of its nuclear-capable Agni 4 missile. After the routine user training launch test of the Agni 4, the Indian government said that the successful test reaffirms India's policy of having a credible minimal deterrence capability. As previously mentioned, the Prithvi ballistic missile is the first indigenously built ballistic missile developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization, or the DRDO, under the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. India's road mobile short-range ballistic missile, with the first two variants being single-stage, two engines and liquid fuels. The development of this missile began in 1983 and was first fired on February 25, 1988. There are three versions of the Prithvi missile. The Prithvi, being a nuclear-capable missile, will have enough deterrence value for both Pakistan and China, as the targets located in these two countries within the range of Prithvi can be easily targeted, said the Indian Lieutenant Colonel J.S. Sauday, retired. Similarly, the DRDO also developed the Agni series of the ballistic missiles under the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. This series included missiles capable of hitting targets varying from short, intermediate, long range. The Agni missile was first launched May 1989, a year after the Prithvi missile. It is a two-stage missile, with the first stage utilizing the first-stage solid-fuel booster motor of the SLV-3 satellite launch vehicle. According to the Indian Lieutenant General J.S. Sauday, retired, said, "The biggest difference between the Prithvi and the Agni missile is the distance and the payload capacity. While Prithvi has a range of 150 to 500 kilometers, Agni 5 has a range of 5,500 to 8,000 kilometers. It puts all of China and Pakistan. Prithvi carries a warhead of 500 to 1,000 kilograms, while Agni carries a warhead worth of 1,500 kilograms. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and please support us by clicking the thanks button below our video. Asserting that India is on the side of peace, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on Monday that India believes there will be no winner in the Russia-Ukraine conflict and there will be losses. Addressing a joint press event with German Chancellor Olaf Scholz in Germany, Modi said that from the start of the Ukraine crisis, India has called for an immediate cessation of the hostilities and stressed that the talks are only a solution to resolve the dispute. He also said, "We believe that there will be no winner in this war and all will suffer losses. Therefore, we are on the side of peace. Due to the disturbance caused by the Ukraine crisis, oil prices are skyrocketing. There is a shortage of food grain and fertilizer as a result, which every family in the world has been burdened," said Mr. Modi of India. Indian Prime Minister Modi also said that the effect of this on the developing and the poor countries will be much more. He also said India is also concerned about the humanitarian consequence of the conflict. On his part, Scholar said that Russia has violated the UN Charter by attacking Ukraine. He said he also invited Prime Minister Modi of India to the G7 summit in Germany. Modi had arrived in Berlin on Monday morning, and the first leg of his three-nation Europe trip that will also take him to Denmark and France. Ukraine on Monday said that its Turkish-made military drones, Bayraktars, sank two Russian patrol boats near the Black Sea's Snake Island, where the Ukrainian soldiers rebuffed the Moscow's demand to surrender at the start of the invasion in February. Two Russian Raptor boats were destroyed at the dawn today near the Snake Island, Ukraine's defense minister said in a statement. The defense minister also released grainy black and white aerial footage showing an explosion on the small military vessel. Raptor patrol boats can carry up to 3 crew and 20 personnel. They are usually equipped with machine guns and used in reconnaissance or landing operations. The Snake Island became a symbol of Ukrainian resistance after a radio exchange went viral in which the Ukrainian soldiers rebuffed the demands from the crew of Russian warship to surrender. The Russian ship, the Moskva, which sank in the Black Sea in mid-April, following what Moscow said was an explosion on board, while Ukraine said, and it came to be true by and confirmed by the US, which Ukraine had hit the warship with its indigenously built Neptune missiles. India has cancelled orders of MiG-29 fighter jets, Mi-17 V-5 helicopters and anti-tank weapons from Russia in the last few weeks, a senior United States official claimed, according to a report to the Indian Express of India on March 4. The official Assistant Secretary of State for the South and Central Asian Affairs, Donald Liu of United States, made the statement before the United States Senate Foreign Relations Committee a few weeks before. India's defense minister has not responded to the claim as yet, but slowly India is confirming it by cancelling its helicopter purchases from Russia and other things to come. Mr. Liu said that it will be difficult for any other country to continue purchasing military equipment from Russia after the United States imposed sanctions on Moscow. Russia can't get any microchips or electronics for its military equipment or for its exports. The Indian Air Force would now be supporting for an indigenous program for its helicopters. India has been strongly working towards indigenization in the defense sector and has put on hold or cancelled a large number of contracts for imports in the recent past, according to Indian media reports. The Mi-17 V-5 is produced and manufactured in Kazan, a city in southwest Russia, a subsidiary of a state-owned helicopter design and manufacturing called the Russian Helicopters. It is a modern military transport helicopter used by the Indian Air Force. These Russian helicopters are part of the large family of high-performance and multi-purpose Mi-17s that can fly at high altitude and complex weather conditions, be it in tropical and mountain climate or even in the desert conditions.